Gonzalez tied things in the eighth inning with a single off of Aroldis Chapman. But then Miguel Montero, pinch hit grand slam, helped the Cubs to the win of the opener. Next night, a solo shot by Gonzalez provided all the scoring. And then Clayton Kershaw retired the first 14 Cubs. He allowed just two hits in seven. That tied up the series. And then it shifted to L.A. Game three, Rich Hill dominating six shutout innings. Yasmani Grandal, Justin Turner, they each homered to give the Dodgers a 2-1 series lead. But the Cubs' bats came alive in game four. Addison Russell, Anthony Rizzo, well, they would break out of slump with a homer and three hits apiece. A 10-2 win that knotted this series at two. Moving to game five, it was John Lester on the mound doing his thing. Seven sharp innings. And then the offense from Addison Russell going to go ahead home run. Cubs would then pour it on to get out of the doorstep of their first World Series trip since 1945. And that's where we stand here tonight. It'll bring us a rematch of game two from this series. Clayton Kershaw, who has been lights out this postseason, against Kyle Hendricks, who went 5 1/3, allowed just three hits and one run in that game two. That game, that run, a solo home run to Adrian Gonzalez, who is now standing by with our Ken Rosenthal.